The future of biotech is already here in the realm of medical diagnosis, where Taiwanese innovation permits doctors to safeguard the lives of patients with chronic diseases by predicting negative outcomes before they occur. It's 8:30 in the morning. At Taipei's Tri-Service General Hospital, Tong Shengxue's wife and daughter are getting him ready for his dialysis. Xue began receiving dialysis regularly 9 years ago when he developed an end-stage kidney disease due to diabetes.
那我每星期洗4次，所以我都在3.5小时左右。
Dialysis is used to remove waste, fluids, and extra chemicals from the blood in patients who lose kidney function. However, electrolyte imbalances are common among patients undergoing dialysis, significantly raising their risk of sudden death.
那一天，可以讲忽然间心跳很不舒服。那我看血氧机，心跳从60跳50，又破40，39，我赶快来急诊。我来的时候，我就意识不太清醒，林教授就做了心电图跟验血。Dr.
Xie Hualin, a world-renowned nephrologist, specializes in electrolyte imbalances.
电解质异常，特别是钾离子，会引起心率不整，那会导致突然的猝死。钾离子异常，不是那么快就可以诊断出来，靠抽血。那实验的报告需要的时间大概约1个小时。For
patients suffering from cardiac arrest, 1 hour may be too late. The Tri-Service General Hospital has deployed AI diagnostics to determine the cause of cardiac emergency.
那时候林教授从心电图就可以判读我血钾浓度有7.22多。
Instead of getting defibrillation at the ER to resuscitate the heart, Cher was ordered dialysis immediately. An hour later, the blood test revealed that the value of his potassium level upon arrival was a dangerously high 7.5 milliequivalent per liter. But by then, thanks to the dialysis treatment, Cher's condition had stabilized. Normally, the potassium level in the blood stays between 3.5 to 5.5 milliequivalent per liter. A patient suffering from dyskalemia will have a potassium level above or below the normal range. Hypokalemia is diagnosed when the value goes below 3.5, and hyperkalemia when the value exceeds 5.5.
2016年，我们就开始成立了，我们用心电图来判断血钾的异常。
AI can be taught to quickly diagnose dyskalemia without waiting for a patient's blood results, simply by analyzing real-time ECG data. Dr. Qin Ling, an assistant professor at the National Defense Medical Center, trains the AI model to do the job.
我的工作主要是负责模型的训练。最开始的时候，我总共拿到了66000笔心电图及血钾这些资料。Qin
Ling feeds data to the AI model and guides it learning.
医师在这里面最重要的角色，就是去建立大量的标注数据，如心电图以及它对应的血钾浓度。人工智慧就会自己去发掘它们两者之间的相关性。Dr.
Xue Hualin keeps a detailed journal of his patients' lab tests. He and Qin Ling are amazed by the result.
依照目前我们反复的训练，针对血钾的异常，比医生能够准确判断的高出至少10%到20%左右。The
Tri-Service General Hospital's AI model is one of the first in the world to succeed because it holds a unique advantage over other hospitals.
严重低血钾跟严重高血钾的病患数非常的少。
But Dr. Xue Hualin treats more than two-thirds of the patients with dyskalemia in Taiwan. This translates to richer data for the AI model.
我们现在的心电图总共有70万张以上，有血钾浓度的心电图，那至少也有20万张以上。
目前大概我们只要做了心电图，一上传，大概5秒钟就可以看到报告。
The cloud-based AI system analyzes patients' ECGs in real time and immediately alerts the health team when dyskalemia has been detected.
只要 AI 已经知道这是危险的，都可以透过简讯让临床的医师、护理师、主治医师、值班的都会知道。
The AI team hopes to expand the reach of the rapid detection system beyond the hospital.
未来的计划主要是希望先把人工智慧判读系统先跟消防局做合作，把它应用到全省的救护车上，让其他医院都可以使用到，从而提升台湾整体的医疗品质。
The demonstrated ability of the country's healthcare system to test and implement digital innovations explains why the future of biotech is already here in Taiwan.